Has your abdomen been stretched by weight gain and weight loss or pregnancy? You may have excess fatty deposits or loose stretched skin below your navel that will not respond to dieting and exercise. If your lower abdomen appears disproportionate with the rest of your body, a mini tummy tuck or partial abdominoplasty may be your best option for a firmer, flatter abdomen. A mini tummy tuck is less complex than a full tummy tuck because the position of your navel is unaffected and the incisions are typically smaller. Tummy tuck procedures can be performed alone, but are often performed with liposuction to further improve body contours. Individuals considering a tummy tuck should be healthy, relatively fit, and not planning future pregnancies, as this may re-stretch tightened muscles. Depending on your specific requirements and surgeon's preference, a mini tummy tuck may be done under local anesthesia with sedation, where the abdominal area is numb and you are relaxed and comfortable. Alternatively, you may be completely asleep under general anesthesia. The length of time required for a mini tummy tuck procedure depends on the amount of tissue being removed and whether liposuction is also performed. Your surgeon will make an incision just above the pubic area. The incision is typically made where it is hidden by bathing suits or undergarments, but it is important to realize that you will have a scar. The skin and fat layers that lie above the abdominal wall are separated from the wall using an instrument such as a cautery device. The tissue is then lifted upward toward the navel to expose the abdominal muscles of the lower abdomen. Your surgeon will suture these muscles, pulling them closer together, which creates a flatter, firmer abdominal wall and a slimmer waistline. Once the muscles are tightened, the layer of skin and fat will be stretched back over the abdominal wall, and excess skin and fat that hang beyond the original incision are removed. Drainage tubes will likely be placed in the abdomen through tiny holes below the incision, allowing fluids to escape as you heal. The incisions will be sutured and bandages will be applied. You will likely need to wear a compression garment to minimize swelling and provide comfort and support while you heal. Drainage tubes and sutures will typically be removed within a week or two after the surgery. As with any surgery, moderate pain, bruising, and swelling after the procedure are normal and will typically subside within several days. Pain can be controlled with medication if recommended by your surgeon. Your scar will fade considerably over time. You will notice an improvement in the appearance of your abdomen soon after your procedure, and your results will gradually continue to progress. With proper diet and exercise, you can have a firmer, flatter abdomen and start enjoying the new you.